Hey guys, welcome to Pokemon Mystery Dungeon Blue Rescue Team. It's a Pokemon game and I like it. Let's go play it. Cause... Okay, hold on. First, I need to start a new game. So, I'm gonna do that. Let's see, data. I'm borrowing this from a friend and he said I could play it, so I'm gonna do that now. New game. Welcome. This is the portal that leads to the world of Pokemon. But before I can let you through, I have several questions for you. I want you to answer them sincerely. Are you ready? Okay. Let's the interview begin. So this little interview thing here will pretty much decide what Pokemon you will be playing as in the game. So let's go find out. You're going bungee jumping for the first time. Since it's scary, you decide to test the jump with a doll. And the bungee cord snaps. Oh my. Are you willing to make the jump anyways? It just snapped with a doll. I'm pretty sure I'm heavier with the doll. No. No, fuck that. I don't know why I tested it in the first place, but holy shit. Somebody calls you weird but funny. How does that make you feel? Happy. At least I'm funny. I don't mind being weird. Do you sometimes run out of things to do all of a sudden? Yes. Do you dream of lounging around idly without much excitement? That's stupid. Grab any digit on your left hand. Grab any digit on your left hand with your right hand. Which digit do you grab? Let's see. I'm gonna go with... you. That's a weird question. There's a bucket. Yeah, there is a bucket. If you put water in it, how high will you fill it? I don't know why I'm filling this with water, but probably full. Why not? Do you like to imagine things for your amusement? Of course. It is a pleasant day at the beach. How do you feel? Neat. Are you a boy or a girl? Boy. You appear to be the naive type. That's fantastic. You have a high curiosity and love rare things. Your cheerful and carefree attitude should make things fun for people around you. But you do have one flaw. You can be childish. You can never sit still. You're always on the move. You can always be selfish, so you should watch yourself. Oh, can also be selfish. Whatever. A naive person like you should be a Totodile! Fuck yes. I love Totodiles. They're like the best Pokemon ever. This is the final step. Who would you like to have as a partner? Choose the Pokemon you want as a partner from this group. Okay. What do we got here? Okay, Cyndaquil. Let's go with Cyndaquil. Yep, going with Cyndaquil. Cyndaquil will be named... fuck. Gotta think of names now. Okay, I'm gonna go with this. I'm gonna go with Atlas because that's what I named my Typhlosion. Because why not? Okay, there we go. Is that spelled right? Fuck. That's not spelled right. Atalas. Atalas. There we go. Named my Typhlosion that because he makes the world go boom with the eruption, because eruption's pretty awesome. Although, we're probably never gonna get that moveset on here. If we do, then holy shit. Okay, we're all set. Let's get into your into the world of Pokemon. Go for it. Where am I? Am I dreaming this? I feel a pleasant breeze. I hear a voice from somewhere. I wonder who it is. Dots. More dots. And a lot more dots. Excuse me. Please wake up. Come on, wake up. So I'm gonna be Gen 2 Stardust. Hooray! This is like my heart gold playthrough right now, because I have both of these starters on there. And they're working out wonderfully. You're finally awake. Great. Where is this? You have passed out here. I'm glad to see you awake. I'm Atlas. Glad to meet you. You're so fucking happy. And you are? I've never seen you around before. I am a Pokemon trainer. I train Pokemon for a living. Huh? You're a human. How are you not reacting to the first... How am I not reacting to the Pokemon talking first? I'm just conversing with it. I don't know. I'm having a normal conversation with it at the moment. But you look like a normal Totodile in every way. It's true. I've turned into a Totodile. But why? I don't remember anything. You're kind of weird. What's your name? My name? That's right, my name is... There we go. Oh, Lynx is your name. Well, it's a funny name. What a jerk. I can't be your friend anymore. I'm kidding. I love you, Atlas. Somebody, please help me. Huh? I hear shouting from over there. It's a Butterfree. What's wrong?
It's horrible! My Caterpie fell into a cavern! My poor baby!
What?
A huge fissure opened up in the ground and my Caterpie fell in! He's too young to crawl out himself! When I went to get my baby, a Pokemon suddenly attacked me!
Huh? You were attacked? By other Pokemon?
They must be enraged by the fissure! And out of control, that's what I think. Well, I'm not strong enough to fend off the wild Pokemon. What will become of my baby? Oh, what am I to do? Oh dear, oh dear.
This sounds bad. We have to go help. So basically, the Pokemon in this world, while they do have the capability of normal speech and, like, not being an ass, they can be a complete asshole. Okay, I need to... Whoops. Okay, hold on. Okay, there we go. Now I have the map on the top, and all this on the bottom. And now we... Shit. I need to set you as my L plus A... No, my R plus... I don't know. Yeah, my L plus A move. So I automatically scratch. It's great! Can I talk to you? Let's see, how do I just look? There we go. I'm going for it, Lynx. You do that. Let's go save that baby Caterpie. Got a lot of dungeon to cover. At least this is like the beginning one, so it should not be too deep. There's a Wurmple. Go away, Wurmple, you're not what I'm looking for. I'm looking for a Caterpie. And I don't think you're, Hi, you're sleeping. Goodbye. I'm a jerk. Sneak attacks. The best attacks. Did I finish my thought on what Pokemon are in this world? I don't know if I did. Okay. So, this will be basically a tutorial level, like, teaching you how to do the game and stuff. And Atlas learned how to use Smokescreen. Hopefully, him being a fire type will not, hold on. I want to see what his ability is, because I may not enjoy him otherwise. Let's see. You can use Smokescreen, because that's sort of helpful. Yeah, those are fine. Team, what's your abilities? What's your tactic? Okay, yeah, you don't have any problem. You're fine. You're a fire mouse. Crazy. I didn't actually realize he was considered a fire mouse. Okay. So where are those stairs? There's Pidgey. Goodbye, Pidgey. Goodbye, worm. Boo. Still not what I'm looking for. And I leveled up. Awesome. Look at them stats. Okay, so if I haven't explained this, in this game you play as you're basically a human who's been turned into a Pokemon, and you're basically just trying to figure out what the fuck's going on with that, and living your life as a Pokemon until then. And by living your life as a Pokemon, you end up joining some like rescue team and beating up everything. You're helping the world while you don't understand what the hell's going on with you. It's perfectly fine. Hello, execute. Goodbye. I just beat up a bunch of sleeping babies. It's fine. Fetch berries, healing poison. Oh. You weren't hurt. You weren't here earlier. Go away. Whoops. I meant to use Scratch. Okay, continuing. Oh, found the worm ball. I mean Caterpie.
Where? Mommy, where are you? Sniffle.
We came to rescue you.
Huh?
Your mom's waiting. Let's go get you out.
Okay.
My baby's safe!
I'm sorry. I don't know how I could ever thank you properly.
That's okay. It's been dangerous lately with all the sudden quakes and fissures like that one. It's great to find your little boy unharmed.
Please, may I have your names at least?
I'm Atlas, and this is Lynx. Dude, he looks amazed. Cool. He's staring at me adoringly. Those sparkling eyes, it's a little embarrassing. But this doesn't feel bad either. It's like I'm a hero. My fucking Pokemon is getting a big ass ego right now. Helping Pokemon in trouble might be a good experience.
Thank you, Atlas and Lynx.
I know this isn't really enough, but this is a token of our thanks. Please accept it.
We received an Oranberry. The promised Oranberry. We were never promised an Oranberry, were we? We're getting a lot of berries.
Thank you so much. Goodbye.
Thanks for you for helping. You're very tough. I was sure impressed. So, what are you gonna do? Do you have any plans?
No.
Listen, Lynx. If you don't have a place to stay, you should come with me. And now we're gonna go bum around at Cinquil's house. Well, this is the place. It's pretty small, but it's decent. Looks okay. And I'm a Totodile. I love the water. Wow, I can't explain, but I'm happy. It's because there's water everywhere. It's like awesome for you. I'm a human being, but this place I feel weirdly happy. It might be an instinct for Pokemon, probably. Maybe this is what it feels like to want to wag your tail. It doesn't matter, I'm happy. Maybe I feel this way because I'm a Totodile. Because Totodiles are always fucking happy. Oh, Lynx, you're impressed, aren't you? I thought so. I thought this would make a good place for you to live. I was sure you'd like it. This is your mailbox. They deliver a mail from Pokemon here. You know, just like the Fissure Caterpie fell into. For some reason, they've had many natural disasters lately. Because of those disasters, many Pokemon are suffering. I want to help the Pokemon in these tough times. I want to help change things so all Pokemon can live in peace. Well, I like how you handled yourself when we rescued Caterpie. Would you like to join me on a rescue team? Lynx, with you, I think we could become the world's best rescue team. How about it?
No.
Okay. Yeah, if I refuse, he'd probably just keep on trying to convince me. I'm pretty sure it's one of these kind of games where you can't say no to those. Perfect. That's it then. My partner is in our rescue team from now on, Lynx. Glad to have you on board. The team's name. Well, I don't have one yet. So, Lynx, what do you think would be a good name for us? Oh, fuck. Gotta think of another name! It's hard to think names, because I haven't played this game in such a long time, I don't remember anything about these. Like, I don't remember the partner's personality, I don't remember the overall story of this game, and yeah, usually I'd base things based off of that, but I don't fucking know. Okay, fuck it, we're going with Boiled. Because I'm water, and he's fire, and we can make boiled water. Boiled... Oh, I have enough space for this. I'm going for it. Boiled water. That's our team name. Oh, it fit in perfectly. That's great. Boiled water? I like it. It's a good name for us. It's perfect for us. Rescue team Boiled Water. Oh my god, I really just did this. Okay. Let's do good starting tomorrow. Hooray! Team Boiled Water! What the fuck? And that is how Lynx and Atlas began their careers together as the rescue team. Pokemon Mystery Dungeon, Blue Rescue Team, just in case you forgot what you were playing.